Hello and welcome back to another episode of Toy Therapy. I'm the host, the Toy Therapist, aka Matthew Grant, and today I'm looking, as you can see, looking at another Star Wars Black Series figure. In my last review, I did a review of K2SO, which is a droid I hold very close to my heart, right up there with R2-D2, all because they give a lot of sass. As you can see now, I'm looking at C-3PO. Absolutely love him. Absolutely love him. He's just that droid that you just... is so... recognizable with Star Wars, right there with Stormtroopers. If you see this particular character, you know you're going to be looking at a Star Wars character. It's just one of those givens. But anyway, let's go particularly around the actual box and see what he's what. This one was an exclusive. I can't remember what the exclusive was, if I can remember. I just can't remember. So there's no particular number on him. Nothing at all. But if you do want to read the back, you can. If someone can remember what exclusive it was, please let me know below. I just can't remember for the life of me. Normally they do have numbers, but this one particularly doesn't have a number. So I can't really remember if it was an exclusive or not. But anyway, someone will dare tell me at the bottom in the comments, just to remind me. So if you do, thank you so much if you can. But anyway, let's get to the figure. As you can see, C-3PO is out of the packaging, and this was one of my favourite droids for many, many years until a certain droid came along, but I'll get to that in a few moments' time. So as you can see, it is C-3PO, and this is one of the most iconic droids right up there with R2 and as well the... The Day the Earth Stood Still, the Android. I can go on for robots for quite a while, so I'd rather just cut it there and then just carry on, just talk about C-3PO. Basically, this is a protocol droid, and you've seen him in different colours. You've seen him in white, you've seen him in like a silver, you've seen him in red, you've seen him in all sorts of different colours. But basically, gold is what we're used to, and this is our first interaction along with a silver one in A New Hope. So this is what we had. Anthony Daniels made this character come to life as well. And just having that comedy duo with R2-D2, almost very similar to like Abba Costello and Morgan Wise, and I can carry on going on with some of the best double acts. I know I would have missed out. There's so many double acts to think about as well, I not as well say. And one of my ultimate favourite double acts, not as Albert Costello, is Laurel and Hardy. So, but anyway, enough about that. Let's get to the actual figure. So, they've done a couple of droids now in this type of thing as well. So, I haven't got to those ones yet, but I'll get to those soon. And as well, I've been thinking about doing customs on this particular droid, which I've just about finished a couple, so I might do that in a forthcoming video soon, maybe. Go for my first and my second attempt, and now at the moment I'm doing a third, and I know someone is asking for a certain droid to be done, so I'll get a chance to do him as well. So let's go around the articulation. So you're getting a really good head movement, you're getting a really good sort of arm movement, so there's no extra swivels there at all, nothing on the old elbow, because you've got this in its way on L4 Lom as well, one of the bounty hunters. This is actually done a bit different, so you can sort of move this actual arm, which you can't on this one. This was like the first iteration of the protocol droid. You're getting a bit of a mid-rift movement there. And as well, you are getting a bit of a twist on your thigh, and you're getting a really nice, simple knee joint as well. And you are getting a bit of a tilt and up and down movement on the old feet and ankle. So this doesn't have an awful lot of articulation. But do I care? No, I don't. Because basically C-3PO is not known for much articulation. For me at the moment, it's all about the features, okay? The gold finish is absolutely gorgeous. It's nice, sort of like, like a gloss on it as well, really nice metallic-y type gold, which does shine really well. Okay, the eyes, absolutely fantastic. Even though they're meant to be just like orange, not orange, like yellow, they've done a bit of like a gold and a white as well to look like it is actually lighting up as well. And if you got the Baba Freak set from the Last Jedi, okay, if you put your thumb over here, or hot water, I think, or cold water or something like that, they do go red as well. So that's on the new one, which I haven't got, actually. I've been trying to get hold of that one just for Baba Freak. That's all I want it for. But really, it's all about the finish. I mean, the hands are done really well. The wiring is done lovely. And same on the back. Like I said, the silver leg is iconic as well. It pops really well. There's no real blemishes anywhere, but the detailing is good. And like I said, the head sculpt is perfect. It is a really good droid. Is it one of my favorites? It was for a time, and I'll get to my favorite droid in another video. But other than that, though, this is really a basic figurine. It's all about the little touches, and they nailed it. We've only had this one. They had the 40th. They had an anniversary one. They had the one with the red arm, which I use for customs because I don't like the one with the red arm because I think it's just stupid. And they had the Baba Freak one and the double pack with the removable arms and things like that with Empire Strikes Back, where he was on the back of Chewbacca as well. So really, really, you only had him a few times. But, and as well, there was another droid as well with Dr. Abra as well. Basically, that's another poker droid, but it's just got extra attachments on his old hands there. But other than that, though, you only had him a few times. Compared to Stormtroopers, well, they're like a dime a dozen or a pound a dozen, whatever you want to call it. But anyway, this is enough on C-3PO. I really like this figure. I just love the finish. And I really think they could have maybe done this as a carbonized. If they do a carbonized version, I will definitely will get it. Because I think it is due a carbonized. And I think it would really would pop so well. So well. So Hasbro, make a carbonized version. But anyway, this is Toy Therapy signing out. Until next time, please give me a like, share, subscribe. That'd be fantastic. Drop me a comment below. Let me know what your favorite droid is as well. And if you're interested in doing customs, let me know what you work on. Or even if you want to see my custom videos or some of my other work I've been doing lately, please let me know. And I'll do a video of that some point soon. But anyway, take care. Stay safe. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.